Are you sick and tired of searching for the perfect software for your business? Well, stop searching and why not start building? It's the year 2025. You can build your own custom software with AI, and it's a lot simpler than you think. So let me show you how. Perhaps you've heard of a website called Lovable, where you can create apps and websites by chatting with AI. However, as I've reviewed Lovable, most people are using it for websites and not actual working apps. Or you may have heard of a tool called Replit, which does create custom apps, but it will create anything for any purposes, including building games so that you can sell them on the App Store. Yes, that's right. That's a Pokemon icon, and I have a funny feeling you are not wanting to create a Pokemon-related app. No, we want to create something for your business, something that works with your team, something that works with your clients, and that is customized to your needs. So we are taking a look at Knack, which is only for business users with real problems and who are looking for real solutions. So whether that is project management, whether that is building a CRM, whether that's building a client portal, we can do all of that right here with Knack. And the best part, we can do it by having a real ongoing conversation with Knack's AI App Builder. So let's dive in. Now, here is our prompt box. I'm going to go ahead and paste in my prompt that I already created. So I've got some specific details. I'm looking for a flexible CRM system. I'm telling it about some of the key information that I want to see, some automations, some other things that I want to see in there. But don't worry, this isn't the end of our conversation. Whatever Knack produces in its first iteration, we can continue to modify in real time. So I'm going to go down here and select create, and it's going to start to build custom software based on my needs. And in approximately 2 minutes, in my example, it has produced my consulting CRM interface, a complete application. This is more than just one screen. This is more than just one page. You can see here up to the right. In fact, it's provided 6 different areas here, including my dashboard, an area for clients, projects, interactions, documents, and a place to manage and also send and receive my invoices. So I'm viewing this in real time, just like you. I haven't previewed this yet, but look at this. I've got a great dashboard that I can see some of the main things that are going on. Of course, this is dummy or sample data, but we can import our own pieces of information as well. If I go to the client side, it has provided me with a search field so I can easily search for my clients and then dive into those clients down below. I've got an area for projects. And yes, this is more than just a line item, right? If I click on this, it's going to open up. This is a complete working interface, right? So everything is connected together. In this case, my client is named David Brown. I've got a payment milestone. I know exactly what the status is. I see related documents, related invoices. It may take you a bit of time to sort of wrap your head around of how detailed this is. Remember, this is not a website. This is not just something that looks cool. This is fully functional, something that we can use, start to use and implement on a daily basis. If I stick with that customer, David Brown, here I've got that invoice details down below and I can edit that invoice. It's more than just being able to click into any field, which I know that many of you are often worried about when it comes to applications like Notion, where everything seems to be editable. Well, don't worry, you can change that here as well. But here's the real magic. Now that we've taken a look at the first draft of this application, here on the left-hand side is where we are interacting with the app builder. So first off, it's given us a bit of an overview of what it built for us. So rather than just randomly poking around and clicking on these different areas, we can actually read and say, oh, what exactly did you create for us? What are the different tables and the different fields here? This is a very helpful section, relationships and fields. Okay, I get it. Projects to the client, interactions are also connected to the client. So you can run through this and identify, you know, how things are sort of set up. But it's not over yet. In fact, you may want to keep playing with this for the next hour or so to refine it. But better yet, as your business grows or as your business changes, you can continue to refine it. So for example, coming back to the projects page, we can search for a project and then we have our projects down below. But I want to make this that much more productive. I don't want to add another tab or another page. Instead, I'm coming down here and in the chatbot, I'm saying on the projects page, I want an area that highlights the top three key tasks that I need to do this week. Okay, so again, we are going to be interacting in real time and we can tell it anything we want. Do you want to change the colors of the buttons? Do you want to rearrange the layout? Do you want more detail around these projects? Do you want less details? Do you want to reorder things? Are there things that are completely missing? Are there things that you've seen in other applications that maybe you've paid for or maybe are too expensive that you'd like to see here? You can tell it anything you want here and it is going to build or edit your application for you. So let's go ahead with this prompt. Now, after submitting, the first thing that Knack is going to do, it's going to help clarify what it is that I want. So it's going to analyze that particular page, and then it's come up with a plan. It's actually giving me two options. The reason why I really love this, now it's not always going to give you options. If it's a simple request or something very simple, like perhaps changing the color or of a button or an order of a column, that's pretty straightforward. But in this case, I was kind of vague, right? I want this area for my top three tasks. Well, I would rather it ask me some follow-up questions so it gets it right the first time and maybe even gets me thinking about some other things as well, rather than just rearranging things on screen and having to go back and forth that much more options. So I'm gonna say option one. It's given me two options. I'm gonna say option one in this case. And then again, depending on how complex your request is or your change, it could take up to perhaps a full minute to implement, but perhaps what I appreciate the most is that it's not going to go ahead and redevelop everything else on the screen or redo your entire application. It's only going to fix or edit the things that you tell it to. Now, a few seconds later, I've got my top three priority tasks. My high and two mediums are listed here, and they're coming directly from this new table, this new task list, which is going to be attached or related to the projects that I specify. Now, once again, this is all sample data, which I really appreciate because it makes you naturally think of how you would or how you could use this area. But we still have our projects. This is still the projects page, but now I've got my top three priorities as I requested. Now I can continue to alter this. I can change the location. I can change the format of that. Speaking of which, let's go back to the dashboard because I want to spend as much time here. So maybe I don't need to jump into my other areas quite as often. And I'm a very visual person. So I would really like to have a graph or maybe a pie chart as a part of this screen. So this time I'm going to give it the following prompt. On the dashboard, add a pie chart that shows each customer name and the total invoice amount. Once again, the Knack AI App Builder will ask me if the following plan suits my needs. It's telling me exactly what it's going to do before it's going to go ahead and build it. This actually saves me a lot of time, so I don't have to go back and forth and say, no, that's not quite right. That's not what I meant. It's going to go ahead and build it for me. And look at this. In just a few seconds this time, it has confirmed exactly what I wanted. Here's my breakdown of the different customers and how much they owe or the size of their invoice. And it even creates a built-in filter. So I can filter this pie chart. It's more than just a nice graphic, but it's interactive as well. Now, when it comes to actually using your app, we can jump up here to say, go to the live app. And this is what it's actually going to look and feel like for you, your team, or if you're building a client portal, what it's going to look like for your customers as well. And remember, you can add your logos, you can change your colors, you can change other elements as well. But rather than forcing yourself into some other CRM, project management tool, or some other tool out there, you get to build exactly what you want, what you need, nothing more and nothing else. So if you'd like to start solving your business problems with a simple AI prompt, go to knack.com and start building your business tools for free. Thank you so much for watching. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.